Hello and welcome to Geomantic Information Systems. In this episode, we're going to look at the Newark Earthworks, Serpent Mound, the Zocalo in Mexico City, Teotihuacan, and all of these Native American sites' relationship to the Great Pyramid of Giza. In our examination, we'll see how the large octagonal and circular feature at Newark points the way to the Great Pyramid of Giza. We'll also have a look at how the Great Pyramid of Giza itself points to Serpent Mound in Ohio, just a little bit southwest of Newark. Here we see the line extending from the Great Pyramid of Giza. This is a 315.01 degree angle, spanning the globe and reaching Serpent Mound. Here we see the circular feature connected to the larger octagonal feature, oriented to point the way across the globe to the Great Pyramid of Giza. And we see also this angle being very close to the angular orientation of the Great Pyramid of Giza as well. Orange line to Serpent Mound, black line from Newark. The Zocalo or Plaza Mayor of Mexico City may have been the Axis Mundi of the Aztecs. This is the discovery site of the Aztec sunstone, which was first examined by Alexander von Humboldt in 1803. The sunstone has an octagonal scheme and likely, besides its time measurements, indicates directions on the globe. Here we'll plot this picture of the sunstone at its approximate location of discovery in the Zocalo in Mexico City, and we'll plot its even 45 degree angle on the globe. As this transect proceeds to the northwest, it intersects some very amazing places, including a modern spiral feature that seems to have been added on the edge of the line. But it also transects just to the northwest of the Pyramid of the Moon at Teotihuacan. This is an amazing association that a 45 degree angle extends to Teotihuacan. Now if we extend this angle across the globe, we get an even more amazing association, and it transects to the Great Pyramid and Heliopolis to Cairo, Egypt, just about 9 miles to the northeast of the Great Pyramid. We have two of the greatest pyramid complexes in the world aligning, pointed to by the Aztec sunstone. Do these arrangements suggest that there was European interference in pre-Columbian America? In Central America? Had people been here already? Now our choices are that the Native Americans had a value of the Great Pyramid, where people who did came to the Americas and instilled this value in them with these linear associations among others. Many researchers often wonder about the similarities between Egyptian and Central American material culture and architecture. And it could be due to a post-Christ interference in North America. And I have a lot of rationale for this coming up in my upcoming book. Lots of interesting information about Alexander von Humboldt and Thomas Jefferson and how they may have knew about the Great Cross of Hende and the Aztec Sunstone. So thank you. Join me next time and keep your eyes peeled for my new book coming soon.